guys, welcome back. Episode 61. Last episode was excellent. As I said, averaging scores of 4-1. We now have Benfica in the phase 2 of the group stage of the Champions League. Tough group. Hopefully we can get a win out of these two games. A win and a draw would be great. Be super happy with that. And double Arsenal in the middle. Newcastle, let's not forget them. Scored here probably our best. Bowyer's out injured, so Mark Kerr will come into him for into the team as he has been for the last couple of weeks. I'm still a little bit bunged up and whatnot, allergies. It's the same time as when I recorded that first video. I like to do them in a batch. I just had a thought. Do we have anyone who's oddly trained? No, let's go. All right, cool. Jamie, yeah, Benfica. Cool. Let's kick off. Kick off. We're at home. This should be a game we should be winning. And one that we definitely have to. If we lose this game, we could essentially be... We might as well write this Champions League off again. Because up against Bayern and Roma, they're going to beat Benfica. And so Ronaldinho with his fifth of the season. So there's a game. And Ibrahimovic bags another. That is brilliant. You two keep drawing. That'll be even better. We're all over Benfica here with 7 shots on target. But Rafael van der Vaart, let's get a physio report on him. And Mark Kerr has got a shin injury as well. Ronaldinho has got a knee injury. Fudge. Right. It was Mark Kerr, wasn't it? Yep. It was Rafael van der Vaart and... Big Ron. Triple substitution there, because I don't want injuries to them. And we're already 2-0 up, so I feel like we can do that without too much disruption to the team. And yeah, Benfica aren't doing anything. And we've had 15 shots on goal, so we are... But they could get that one, and then it's 2-1, and all of a sudden we look on a little bit. Yep, but it's not. It's a good 2-0 win. Ricardo man of the match, yep, would be with that many shots. Benfica really only gave Sebastian Frey one save to make. Bayern beat Roma 2-0 as well, so... No concerns of Rafael van der Vaart, obviously. We've got Newcastle now in a couple of days. They're 4th. So they'll be looking for Champions League football. 6 points behind us. Chelsea are a point behind us with a game in hand. Jeez. They've been really good this season as well. Very, very similar to us. No losses yet and a really good goal difference. I don't know why this guy is on my short list. He doesn't mean to be. Oh, couple of near little draws there. To Inter. Losing in. They're down to 4th. Jeez, Diego Tristan is going to Milan by the looks of it. That's a strange bit of business by Valencia. Guti's going to Betis as well, where they just bought him from. Another strange bit of business, but whatever. Liverpool's still in the Europa League, even though they're in the relegation zone. I wonder if they're still in there. I can't see them getting relegated. That would be ridiculous. Yeah, they're still there. They're a point off Fulham. Far out. That would be something if they got relegated at the end of the season. It'd almost be worth taking them over and trying to pull them back up. Game in hand though. Lose that game, then they're in big trouble. Big, big trouble. Diego Tristan going to Milan from Valencia. It's going to be a... Liverpool have been beat by Coventry. 3-0. Oh my god. Chelsea have leapfrogged us for the first time. Yeah, they're on fire as well. Howard, good Johnson, Leon Knight. But Liverpool are bottom of the table. Who's in charge? Is it still I wonder where Gerard Houllier left Liverpool and went to Manchester United. What? Bizarre. He's a good manager though. Look at those stats. Got 11 for physiotherapy as well. Alright. Yeah, we're good here to play the regulars. Anyone last game? No, I think we're all pretty good last game. Everyone was really happy with their performance. So we'll leave the team as it is. And we've got to beat Newcastle here. Can't believe how well Chelsea are going. Just I wasn't even paying any attention to them as they've clawed their way up the table, but Van der Vaart, they haven't lost a game, so they're always in second really. Bellamy. And then Palermo. Martin Palermo. Nice signing. Coming from Barcelona. But Carreras finds the net as well to make it 2-2 before half time. And the game is goals a go go. Craig Bellamy, who went on to play for Man City in real life. Little fact there for you. I'm sure you knew that anyway. Alessandro. Oh, and we've got a penalty. Fana, there it is. 4-2. Just like that. Boom, boom, boom. A couple of quick goals, and we are looking a lot more comfortable than we were at half time or just before. Fana it off. Table, we're back up to first. That's what we've got to keep doing with Chelsea still playing like that. We just got to keep winning. This is a good game for us here. Frown of six, Mike Duff, two assists from the wing. Him and Liam Pryor are just, he's an eight. Look at this, just what a player. Liam Pryor, he's averaging eight. Like, that's incredible. Good, they're pleased with that. Right, we've got Arsenal now in a couple of days. And we'll be playing that young-ish team that we kind of do for the League Cup. Righto, we've got Arsenal. And we've got a really good record against Arsenal. Have they ever beaten us twice? Once, can't see it the second time. There it is, the very first time we played them. We are going for that young rotation kind of squad, I guess, whatever you want to call it. We'll see how they go. Arsenal lined up with a strong team. I guess, Lee Tamahan, yeah, Kim Kalstrom, Freddie Ljungberg, Jermaine Defoe is captain. Weird. He's got 20 influence. They signed El Hadj Diouf, and Jeffers is the scorer after 32 minutes. Not the start we wanted. Still, that's what this game's for. Giving some of these youngsters here a shot. I mean, look at these numbers. They're all, the whole front one here is just... Red has a foot injury. Let's get Ronaldo on for him. But we haven't been able to have a shot yet on target. I'm annoyed I played Sambo because he didn't play well last time. But I got a note from my assistant saying that he's been training well and to give him a shot. Maybe it's not him. Let's do this. Whitley's really not. Whitley. Okay, we'll do that. Actually, let's get some mixed passing. Try and create something. I haven't had a shot on target yet. This Richard Wright's not having to do anything. And if we don't grab one here, it says it's an extra time, we're out. And we're out. Ah, there's our League Cup soiree got. Oh well. Like I said, it's not really a thing that we're too concerned about, but it is a first loss in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, I think. No, it's the first loss of the season. Oh no, we lost against Valencia like a month ago. I'm an idiot. What do I know? Right, well, Arsenal again, down in the league in a couple of days. So, very different team though that they'll be playing. So, hopefully, we get one over them, because we really got to do something about this bloody cheat. Chasing Chelsea team, because they are right on our heels, so we don't want to give up any ground to them at this point, because that will be a worry. Oh, there's a central defender we could go for, Guy Branston. No, joking. Hey, another manager of the month. That's our second for the season. Farnerud, player of the month. Doesn't get young player though. Board's happy, obviously. Like, why wouldn't you be? Alright, Frame, Goal, Pinero, Saeed, Caredes. Though, yep, Duff, Yonpo, Cambiasso. Van der Vaart, Farnerud, oh, I can't click, Ronaldinho, Ibrahimovic, Closer on the bench. Closer is playing better than Ibra. Let's swap them over. D'Alessandro, Bakayoko, who's playing better than Nicky Ferenko. Nicky Ferenko's really, really dropped off a bit this season. He was good in our first two seasons, especially the second one, but since then game time has kind of capped him a little bit, and he's not quite the player that we used to have, which could see him actually be sold, and then we move up, like the likes of Hadzmanovic, Ronaldo, Makoko, Red. Still got Andreas Mathisson as well. He hasn't quite progressed. Probably just not really getting the game time, is he? It's a shame. You know what? He's not needed by the club. He could go as well. Alright. Arsenal lining up very similar. We're not though. We've got a good team out. Watch them beat us now that I've been so cocky like that. Chelsea playing. Yes, they are. They're losing to Newcastle. As we just let. Nope, and now we're losing to Arsenal as well, obviously. Brilliant. United pushing up in a second now. This is what I get for being cocky. Oh, play your better team, Arsenal. We're going to wipe the floor with you. 3-1. Frey. Make a change there. Closer off. Oh yeah. That is 50th goal, did that say? Yeah, 50th goal for us because he only scored 5 at Falkirk. Ha! Huh. Bloody hell. What's going on here? Sebastian Frey has decided to have an absolute stonker of a day. We've got a penalty though. Cambiasso off. He's on a yellow as well. Tempted to take Frey off, but. No. Let's do that. Oh, we've pulled one back. Carinas has bagged a second. Can we get a fifth? What a game this would turn out to be. A benign bloody goal thriller. Should probably close the game down, but I think we've got a chance of getting this. Nope, I was wrong. Well, 4-4, we maintain our unbeaten status, but. Wait, did Frey? No, he got a 6. Can't really discipline him for that, can I? It's a bit unfair, isn't it? What have we got? 4 games in. Let's, we're only up to 18 minutes. I think we can fit this Roma game in. It's dangerous trying to cram another game in. As I do that, sometimes it goes strangely pear-shaped, but we've got some time, so let's, you know, I don't know. Alright, we're going to squeeze the Roma game in. We've only ever beaten them once, which, yeah, was last year or whatever. Yeah, so this is how we line up. Possibly a squad, strongest squad. Bowyer's back. Let's actually get Bowyer on the bench. And let's get out and try and grab a draw. I think a draw here would be an excellent result. Away to Roma. They desperately need to win, though. Otherwise, their Champions League campaign is in doubt. We are obviously with the holders. Bayern forgot they won last season. Hernan Crespo puts Roma 1-0 ahead after 33 minutes. With obviously their first shot on target. Sebastian Frey, what the hell are you doing? Crap. It was Nedved. It's Pavel Nedved playing for Roma. Crespo. Ugh. Makes me. Oh. God. He's got knee injuries on a 5 anyway. God, get him off. Get Van der Vaart off. Just going to do the one change. We'll leave it like that. We've got to try and grab something out of this very, very soon. It's not looking good. If Roma score a third here, we're in big trouble. I don't think we can get back into it if they score three. And very small chance getting back into it now. Torres on and Libo, yeah. Try and do something here. We haven't really tested them at all, and I don't think we're going to get anything from this in the end. Sure, Bayern are winning their game. They're drawing with Benfica, and they've just gone ahead. But they're a good team. We're away from home. But that's not good. That's not a good end to the episode or to this part of the Champions League. Right, we have a break now from the Champions League for Christmas. Christmas, January, I think. We come back in February. So we're going to leave it there, guys. Please leave a like. Subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll catch you guys next time. Bye.